What did I know about Agnetha when I first came to Sweden? Well, first of all, I was very much aware of the fact that she was a member of one of the biggest groups in the world, ABBA. I knew, having seen her perform for many years as a member of that group, I knew that she was a very capable singer, very capable performer. I had no problems at all understanding her capabilities, knowing what she was going to be able to do. I knew she was a great singer, and I also knew that our personalities would get along just fine. And I think I've been proved to be right.
One more time, and then we'll move along. Okay. But keep it right, you know. It's not to get.
I knew him as a producer and songwriter. I have listened to a lot of his music. I mean, he has been producing groups like Smokie and Susie Quattro and so on, and I knew he was a very good, one of the most famous producers in the world, and I liked his way of producing, his sound. Mike and Stig Anderson helped me to choose good songs.
Well, since we have been working with ABBA for so long time, we have of course lots of international friends, writers, publishers.
It took about 8 or 9 months to find the songs for this record. One of the things that we were very conscious of was the fact that we had to get new songs. We had to find songs that nobody else had recorded, songs that nobody else had heard, songs that maybe were specifically written for the record. I had most of the songs when I got here, so I had a pretty good idea of how they should turn out. Once I started rehearsing, I think it started to make more sense.
Doesn't matter what you say, don't believe you. Talking love is easy when it's new or true. Slow down, don't move so fast. Not last. I've been wrong before, haven't you? No, don't cry to me. It's just a fantasy. Shame, shame on you. Should know better than to be with a heart that's true.
People at the Polar office to get me the best musicians in Sweden, and they got me the best musicians in Sweden. I also asked that the musicians that we work with were people that Agnetha was familiar with, people that she had been working with before, so that she wasn't surrounded by strangers. The same engineer that she'd worked with for many, many years. And Michael Tretow has, from the very beginning, been an absolute... I couldn't have made this album without him. He's a superb engineer, very creative, and that was important. A studio that she was comfortable with, and a studio this good is anybody would be happy with.
It's exciting to try something new, Making an ABBA album means a lot of compromising, but to do an own solo LP means that you're more free.
What makes a difference? Let's see what happens. We only worked for a week now, so we don't know yet. But that, there will be a difference, of course, because Bjorn and Benny are Bjorn and Benny, and they're writing the songs and producing the album, and this time it's Mike Chapman producing the album, so it's quite a difference.
That song has been nothing but a problem from the beginning. First of all, we had to change the key to suit Agnetha's voice. You see, when you get a song from a male writer, a guy who has written a song and he'll sing the song, sometimes male voice, the range of the male voice is quite different from the range of the female voice. And it meant that some of the bottom notes that she had to sing were perhaps a little bit out of her range, and some of the top notes were a bit out of her range. A very wide scale in the song. So what we had to do was change the key of the chorus, the refrain, so it went from the verse to a different key in the refrain, and in rehearsal it took us forever to work that out, and then we came to record the song, we put the track down, I went to do the vocal on it, and hated it. Hated the track. Just didn't feel good, didn't sound right, so I said, that's it, I'm not going to put it on the record, unless I have time to recut the track. So I found time to recut the track. Eventually got the track right, got the feel on the track right. Plus I have Smokie singing on the background, and I snuck in there as well. I think one of the nice things about doing a solo project is, for both Frida and Agnetha, is they were both able to say, you know, it's like taking the curls out of the hair and letting the hair fall down and saying, right, let's just do this any way we want. There are no preconceived ideas about how Agnetha Fältskog should sound.